Hirata. The headlock's all tied in. The arms under pressure. The tap comes. She's bringing the crowd into it now.
ちっちゃい頃からは柔道好きでしたね。やっぱお兄ちゃんと一緒にやってるのもあったけど、やっぱ柔道が好きでやってました。よく試合を一緒に見に行ったり、格闘技の試合見たり、もともと柔道をやってるのもお兄ちゃんの影響だったんで、そこから練習ついてくれたりして頑張れることが多いです。ずっとオリンピック出たいって言ってたけど、だんだん大きくなるとなんかそうでもないとか思ったり、怪我が多くてなんか柔道あんまり好きじゃないなとかやりたくないなって思い始めた時もありました。もう柔道はできないのかなとか思ったり、ないかもしれないです。柔道やってる時はもうずっとずっと考えちゃいますね。なんて言うんだろう、フラッシュバックっていうか、なんていうか、かけれなかったりで、多分それで柔道が嫌になっちゃう時の方が多かったです。やっぱ一番は家族の支えだったり、周りの人の支えだったり、頑張れって言ってくれる、応援してくれる人のモチベーションを上げました。闘技始めた理由は、もともと柔道やってて、でやっぱ試合見に行くことが多くてって感じです。そっからです。
吸収が早いですね。捉えてそれをすぐ形に生かせてるんで、成長が早いです。来たり来なかったりだし、朝練来た時も中途半端にやってるから、一回本当引っ叩いて、もうやめちまえっつって本当に怒って、あの時しっかり怒ってなかったら、もしかしたらこのまま格闘技中途半端だったのかなとも思いますけど。
デビュー戦はどんなだったっけな。でもなんだろう、全然技も技術も知らない、ただやりたいだけで練習してたんで、なんだろう、今より全然弱かったし、技も技術も全然なかったです。デビュー戦に比べて、日本大会の試合はデビュー戦に比べたら良かったかもしれないですけど、でもまだまだまだまだいっぱいできることあるんで、もっとこれから強くなれるって思ってます。でももっと練習したいし、もっと試合もしたいんで、それ勝ち続けてったらチャンピオンになれるチャンスはあると思います。
These two very talented young women prepared to give us 3 5-minute rounds of mixed martial arts.
Steve, we talked to both these girls earlier in the week, and they both say they want to showcase their striking tonight. Hirata's got 4 submission victories. Ishige, who's also primarily a grappler. Today we get to see how her grappling does. She's been struggling.
And it sends Ishige back onto the deck, and now it's a question of ground and pound. Ishige doing all she can with her legs to try and create distance, but she's not really achieving. Well, there she is. She's got the legs up and pressing her opponent away, creating enough distance to stop those punches coming down. And now they're body to body. Gianni, what a start.
What a start. Right hand by Hirata drops Ishige. Now Ishige in the full guard. This is where we get to see her grappling.
Great thinking from Ishige, who must have been rattled by that right hand that came over the top and landed absolutely flush on the jaw. And all of that action happened inside the first minute. Ishige now gathering a little bit of time to clear her head as she pulls her opponent in nice and close so she can't do too much damage. She's got those legs wrapped around her there, Gianni.
Ishige's looking to throw up a triangle. She's trying to lock up the arm of the Hirata. Got an armbar. Armbar attempt here.
reverse the wrist with me. Hirata looks fairly composed about it at the moment. He's got the positioning to eventually squeeze out. He's locked in there nice and tight. Ishige doing so well with the legs.
Hirata's okay here. He's doing a good job of pressing forward, not allowing her to create the leverage to extend the arm.
The experience that Ishige showed after having received that dramatic punch.
Hirata now in north-south position.
Looking to do some damage perhaps with a knee. There you saw it coming down to the forehead and then switching to the ground and pound.
Hard strikes. Ishige's looking for the, excuse me, Hirata's looking for the key lock.
Again, Ishige pulls her opponent in close to limit the potential for strikes to the face. She's taking away that space with which her opponent can work. Approaching the halfway mark in what has been a pulsating opening first round. Again, the right hands.
Gonna go to full mount. Ishige's got a couple submissions off her back, but this is a bad spot. She's fully mounted right now.
Left hand to the body, just pushing those legs back so she can come around. Looking to grab that throat.
Oh, Hirata here might have a darce. Ishige pops her head back up.
Low to the side of the exit, landing around the right ear of the Thai Japanese woman. Competing under the Thai flag here and throughout her career. But what a pleasure it is for her to be in Japan. It wasn't a pleasure to receive that right hand in the early seconds of this contest, though. Inside the last 2 minutes of this opening round. And again, right hands doing all the damage from Hirata. Hammer blows and punches to the near side of the face as well. And again, Ishige wants to bring her in close and take away that room with which her opponent can work. 100 seconds left.
Ishige had the underhook here, was trying to pop back up, but Hirata did a good job of taking away the post arm. Moving herself back to full guard.
Hirata using those strong legs now to lift her opponent up. See if she can generate that space. And down comes the left hand again. It's been a world of punishment for Ishige. All the while, she's shown tremendous experience and presence of mind to do what she can to minimalize the damage.
We'll go for another key lock attempt.
Right above us here, circle side. Entering the final minute.
Great job by Ishige to use the underhook to sweep Hirata.
All the ground game experience that Ishige can muster here seems to be being utilized in this opening 5 minutes.
This is what we wanted to see today. How Rika Ishige does with another grappler. Oh. Wow, good job by Rika, but now pops slides off the top. And they exchange positions again. Hirata on top.
Both heads jammed against the side of the circle. Ishige still now with her back to canvas. Putting her chin down, trying to just minimize the target. Knee on belly, knee to side of the body there. Just creating enough weight to keep Rika Ishige under control. Approaching the end of the round here. 3 5-minute rounds, Hirata against Rika Ishige, and we're done back for the first 5 minutes. What a pulsating first round that was, and it's all Rika Ishige can do now to make the most of this 1 minute's rest that she has, Gianni, because she was under the cosh right from the start.
Here's the right hand that dropped Rika Ishige in the first one. Came off the break, came off the clinch, and threw that looping right hand that dropped Rika Ishige. And from there, Hirata was able to land a couple follow-up shots, but Rika was able to close the distance, lock her up in the full guard, tie her up.
Actually, you could see from that replay that she had her wits about her all the way through that situation. Her hands were all tied up. She couldn't use them to raise and create any kind of guard. So it was an open shot for Hirata, and she took that opportunity supremely well. 5 minutes down, and we love that. We're into the second round here, and can you believe it? Rika Ishige is smiling at everyone. Everyone who's willing to look. And she's looking directly at her opponent right now as we enter the second round. This is One Century. We are live in Tokyo, Japan. It is Sunday morning here, approaching 10:25 in the morning. And we're into the second round of this contest. Much of it spent on the deck after Ishige was put down by a solid right hand, but they're back on their feet here.
Steve, earlier in the week, Rika said she wanted to take Hirata to the second and third round. Wanted to stay on the bike in the first and the second so that she tires out. She knows that Hirata's got the strength advantage and she wants to stay away from that.
You're absolutely right. She was looking at the long game, wasn't she, when she was discussing tactics with us earlier in the week. And she'll be comfortable. She'll be happy to be here entering the second round, seeing if she can draw her opponent into the third and do the damage there. But another right hand from Hirata, she throws again, gets caught with a left hand as she gets, and there's four big punches now that have gone to the head. She gets caught on the chin again with a right hand, and it's all Ishige can do to move and stay out of range. Hirata looking for the big bomb, and she takes it down to the deck.
Hirata secures the takedown off that right hand. Ishige was taking some shots before this takedown here. Now Hirata's inside half guard, excuse me.
Half guard it is, and Ishige will certainly put that right hand around the back of her neck as she did in the first round to bring her in nice and close, reduce the space with which her opponent can work.
Steve, Hirata has got two key submission wins and she's been hunting it since the first round.
Yeah, submission is the way that she wins her contests, and she's looking for that here. Very much at home, but you can see she's got explosive hands.
She's slowly trying to isolate the arm, the left arm of Rika.
She's
cranking on it now.
Yes. It's looking bad. Ishige managed to just squirrel her way around to take away the impact. She's trying to get back to her feet now, but that constant pressure from above, swirling around the downward weight. Now, up kick, nice one. Perfectly legal because Hirata is on her feet. Kick to the head of a grounded opponent. Those are damaging blows. A heel of the leg as you push it up there. And Ishige is very comfortable there trying to strike out. The question of whether Hirata can get inside that very offensive stance that she has with those heels poised for the up kick. What's the best way in there, Shiani?
There's a lot of ways you can do it. So you can throw the legs across, you can step Boom. Over them. Rika did a good job to stand herself back up.
The referee wants to see constant action for you guys at home, and he just felt that it had reached something of a lull, so he ordered Ishige back to her feet. And at the 2:16 mark of the second round, we're standing again.
Rika needs to start setting up those kicks because Hirata has caught them twice now and landed a counter right.
A little lump forming on the left-hand side of Rika Ishige's forehead, in part due to the big bombs that have been thrown when they're standing up. And Hirata's done well with the ground and pound as well. And that's another solid right hand that landed flush on the jaw, and down goes Ishige again.
Nice work by Hirata. Another step through right hand to secure that takedown.
Thought about just jamming the feet into the hips to push her opponent away, but she's decided instead to just wrap herself around her opponent once more. But she hasn't shut the distance down, which she has managed to achieve previously. There's plenty of room now for Hirata to work. What can she do from here?
Hirata's controlling the arms of Ishige. That denies Ishige the opportunity to throw up submission. Hirata's comfortable here. I was going to look for the key lock again.
It's a favorite move, isn't it? She's always looking for it. Ishige has to be careful of those upper limbs. Don't just leave them hanging out there because they're a target.
Nice job, Hirata. Move the legs past and pass herself the side control.
1 minute left in the second round. Side control, as you say. Ishige just turns her head away, but she gets
it. Hirata's trying to isolate the left arm of Ishige. Wants to set up a possible scarfo arm lock like we scored from Vito earlier.
Right hand still working hard from Hirata. Looking to punish that face.
Wow.
Oh, sweet move.
She's going to the Kimura here. Headlock Kimura.
The
headlock. That's tight.
In. The arms under pressure. The hands. And Hirata takes it late in the second round. She was threatening to do so since the early moments of this contest. She's bringing the crowd into it now. She's improved her record in front of her home fans to 2-0. It's another submission win for strong hard fighter Itsuki Hirata. Rike Ishige now drops to 4-4 after starting out her career with 4 consecutive wins. But wasn't this a sweet move? Nullify the head, you control the body, and that allowed her to work on the arm. And once this movement had taken place and the arm was released, it was never going to be long before Rike Ishige would tap the canvas, signaling to the referee that she'd had enough. And Hirata, out of your picture, is absolutely delighted, beckoning to the crowd to give them all of their love. What a super move that was. Wonderful finish from this young woman. We're going to see plenty more of her.
Ladies and gentlemen, your referee, Mr. Yoshinori Umeki, has called a stop to this contest after 4 minutes and 41 seconds in the second round. For your winner, by way of armbar, Itsuki Hirata!
Stressed before this bout that she wanted to be well known, she wanted the fans to know her, she wants to be famous, she wants to succeed. Very, very ambitious, this woman.
Hey guys, it's Misha Tate. If you want to see more awesome ONE Championship content, make sure you click that subscribe button. Click it so you don't miss it.